right, all right. So now in all of this, oh my goodness, I have like, you know, I haven't been making these vlogs for a while, so I have like this build up that I've got to like, you know, get out all of these you know, details. Okay, so now going back to the Euro centers. Now remember the Euro centers? These are the little tiny small businesses. All of a sudden they have their little items for sale, and they have them for sale like in the Carcassonne area, and then they have them for sale in the United States in the Salt Lake City area. So you have the two centers, and you have those products, the local products able to be easily purchased by buyers. Okay, now these buying centers, the buying centers need inventory equipment, and it has to be very exacting, because a lot of these little towns, like you can take a town in Germany or whatever, and it'll have like one little item that is like their big tuna. That's it. That's what they sell, you know. And maybe they can manufacture even double that amount of what they do normally and sell maybe local in Germany, but they want to expand out. Okay, so in that expansionism, you know, if they get the orders, we have to have an immediate counting system. All right, has to be immediate. Has to be like, you're there at the shop and you're like, okay, I can handle 50 of those a year. I can handle 500. I can handle 5,000. So you're there as the purchaser, the buyer. You place your order for the 5,000 of that particular, because this is a small business. So you've taken that 5,000, and it literally has to be right there on the scorecard. A digital device has to be a digital acceptance, so you can actually. I'm thinking perhaps the buyer themselves will have like a code, a key code. It could be a card, an entry card system where they put in a special number, and they assign 5,000 right then and there. So it gets already put on their shopping cart, essentially. So it's going to be a immediate shopping cart purchase right there at the Euro Center, you know, for these European products, or likewise over here for these American products. Okay, so yeah, so we need something like this. So you have like, there it is, it's because you're only going to have the display item, and it's going to be a clock, you know, this really cool clock. All of a sudden everybody's like, wow, that's a neat clock, you know. And so this little shop says, well, I'll buy 50 of that little clock or whatever. Another one wants 10. So but right there we need to have that deduction. We have to have it state they can only crank out 5,000 of those clocks a year. Okay, they know they can make 5,000. Okay, so we need that, you know, that 50 deducted, and we need that 10 deducted right then and there. So we already know that there's 4,000 or whatever, you know, 940 remaining, you know. So when we're doing sales, we need exacting sales right there in the buying centers. So that makes it, that just makes it like an instant yes, that's what you're getting. You know, so a big supplier can walk in and he can take 500, or a little tiny shop can go in there and take 5, and that's that. Do you understand? No, I understand. And so it's not like, oh my gosh, no, they didn't really have them in stock, and so you don't play that stupid game. Okay, so it's going to be an exact system. So this is something to do with computer technology companies, and I believe somebody out there can handle that one. All right. So that's part of the coalition group here of organizing these major product shopping centers for buyers. Okay. I also wanted to add. I believe, I mean, in reverence to the great African American community in Oakland, I would love to state. The African continent, products from the African continent to Oakland. Okay, now we already know we have the Afro Dance Center, and we have all these fun things going on in Oakland. They have, you know, I believe they even started Kwanzaa. So yeah, everything African product. I would love that mercantile center set up there. Okay, now where in Africa? As an alternative, I think right now we're not going to worry about that. Right now we just need that center right there in Oakland for the African products. Okay. Who am I missing? I don't know. I think that was the major one I wanted to talk about, because I don't know, drifting our little American products into Africa right now, or our European products. Yes, there is a small market, but I don't believe. I think right now it's just going to be the money inflection. We just got to get that money in there and into their trade balance. They need to have that input of cash sent over, and that would be by product production. I don't believe they're in the buying state right now. Okay, so anyhoot. Well, yeah, that was it. The Eurocenter video. Yeah.